One way to enhance student interaction in your class is to use Sakai's Forums tool to generate and encourage online discussions. In this video, we'll create a topic for students to respond to. If you plan on grading your students' posts and replies, you'll need to first create a gradebook item for the topic. We'll start by creating a gradebook item for Week 1's discussion topic. From the course menu, click Gradebook, and then Add Gradebook Item. Type a title for the item. We'll type Week 1 Discussion Topic. Assign points for the discussion topic, and click the calendar to select a due date. Click Create, and a column for the new item appears in the gradebook. Now we're ready to work with the Forums tool to set up a discussion topic. The Forums tool is not a default menu option, so you'll need to add it to your course menu. We'll go to Site Info, and then Manage Tools. Place a check next to Forums, and then scroll down to click Continue. And then click Finish. The Forum tool appears near the bottom of your course menu. I'll click on it to open the forum. By default, Sakai provides a course forum and generates the first topic. Sakai calls this first topic General Discussion. We'll talk more about General Discussion later in this video. As you plan your class discussions, we recommend adding new topics under the course forum rather than creating new forums. This will help your students quickly locate discussion topics. Be aware that students are unable to reply to a forum, so unless you create topics, they will be unable to respond to you and their peers. To create a new topic, locate the existing forums menu and click New Topic. Then type a topic title, such as Week 1 Topic. In the large description box, we'll provide directions for students, such as the question to which they should respond, or a link to a reading for which you'd like for them to reflect. The description box provides plenty of room to type, and below it, you can add an attachment, such as a rubric, to remind students of your expectations. Let's scroll down and take a look at some of the options for this new topic. If you'd like, you can leave all of the default settings as they are, but we'd like for you to have an awareness of the purpose of each option. Locking the topic will disable topic postings. In other words, your students will not be able to create posts to this topic. The Moderate Topic option will require that you moderate or review and approve all posts before they can be viewed by your students. We don't recommend locking the topic, moderating, nor do we recommend encouraging anonymous posts. However, requiring users to post before reading can be very handy. If you choose this option, students will not be able to see their classmates' posts until after they each submit their own initial post. This encourages creative responses and discourages copying what others have already said. Under Availability, you can have the topic show now, or you can specify a date and time when you'd like for it to become visible to students. You can also specify a date when you want the topic to disappear from students' view. However, it might be useful to not include a close date if you wish for your students to have an opportunity to go back and view the content from earlier topics. For now, we'll have the topic immediately appear, and since this will be a graded discussion, in the grading section, I'll select the gradebook item we created earlier. To learn more about grading, watch our video, How to Grade Sakai Discussion Posts. Okay, I think we're ready to save. There we go. The Week 1 topic is appearing under our course forum. Since students will need to click View Full Description to access the topic's instructions, we'll provide students with some guidance. Let's go back to the topic settings and type a short description to let them know that they will need to click on View Full Description to see the question. Make sure to scroll down and click Save. That looks good. Students now have a little tip that tells them to click on View Full Description to access the instructions. Earlier in the video, we mentioned the general discussion topic. This default topic can be a useful repository for gathering student inquiries. You can make the most of it by asking your students to post general questions about the class here rather than emailing you. This way, all students can see and benefit from the answers, and students will often answer each other, saving you some time and effort. If you decide to use the general discussion topic, it'll be important to be explicit in your expectations but also be vigilant in regularly revisiting this topic to view and answer questions. If you decide not to use the general discussion topic, you should delete it by clicking More and choosing Delete Topic. As the semester progresses, your students may find discussion topics provide meaningful conversations about your content, and you may find that encouraging discussion participation with topics are a great way to get to know the thoughts and opinions of your students. If you need assistance with setting up a discussion topic, please contact Sakai Help at durhamtech.edu.